We are at AQS Quilt Week here in Paducah, and this is our very first fall Paducah event. And you know, we did something a little bit different with our judging this year. The judges chose the first, second, and third place quilts in each of the 15 categories. And then we took the first place in each of those 15 categories and opened it up to public voting. And I'm here with one of our top winners, Mary Olson from Almsville, Oregon. Congratulations.
Thank you.
And so you won fifth place overall, yes. Sponsored by Hobbs Bonded Fibers.
Yes, which is amazing considering that's what's inside my quilt.
Oh, that's wonderful. They will like that too. And so tell us what that prize was.
Wow, it was
$6,000.
Yes.
I'm beyond humbled.
And so you started out with a $1,500 first place, and you moved way up to a $6,000 fifth place overall.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I know that everybody would like to know more about your quilt.
Okay.
All right. So first of all, let's start with the design inspiration. How did you decide to make it look like this?
Well, this one was interesting because normally my husband is a primary designer and I could not get him motivated to do a new quilt. He's like, I just can't pull these ideas out of my head. So anyways, I came up and kind of drew some concepts with kind of like the center and how I wanted the color to go out. And I got him enough that the inspiration took off. And so he designed the applique that you see here. And so then I took from paper and then I took that to fabric.
Okay, and so when he designs that, is he designing a fourth, an eighth? How does he do that?
Normally it's a fourth. It's about a fourth of the quilt and kind of odd in the aspect. We'll start from center and go out, and it wasn't towards later in the design that we figured out how we were going to do the top and then we wanted to do the scalloped edges. So it's always a working progress because we collaborate on it, and so we always sometimes have, you know, collaboration of the minds. We know how that goes.
Yes.
But for the most part, we make a pretty good team.
Well, now tell me how you, is this a couch thread or a stitch thread?
That is actually couched. After I finished the entire quilt, I decided to put the satin cording on and I hand stitched it with metallic thread, and there's about 70 yards of satin cording on this quilt.
So tell me how long just that one little process took.
That one probably, I've got probably about 80 hours or so within just that process.
And your applique itself you've done with machine?
Mm-hmm. It is raw edge buttonhole stitching. And at the same time that I'm doing the buttonhole stitching, I'll put a layer of batting behind. And so I kind of kill two birds with one stone. So after I'm done with the applique stitching, I'll cut away that extra batting for trapunto.
Okay. All right. Well, and of course, it's the quilting that is the final touch to every quilt just about. How did you decide to do this style of quilting?
Well, it was interesting. I wanted to bring in both organic and geometric elements to balance the quilt. And the challenge with applique is you want the quilting to accentuate but not take away. So it's trying to get that perfect marriage between the two. And so what I did first was I put the flowers in, and I'll take a heavier paper stock and trace a shape so it makes life easier when you're repeating this.
Right.
And then I quilted this with actually a heavier trilobal polyester. So I wanted the thread to be a little heavier, and then all the pebble stitching and stuff's done in kimono silk. And this was funny because I actually started in the top corner, and so I started and I decided, oh, I'm going to do a bunch of
grid.
tiny stipple stitching. And so after I'd finished the grid work, I started this stipple stitching, and I got about a foot and a half down, and I thought, wow, this looks really pretty. And then I thought, oh, wow, I have a whole bunch of half-inch squares still to go. So it was kind of one of those, aha, oh.
But you know what? It's a wonderful foil of the applique that is curvy and then the straight lines of that geometric quilting.
Oh yeah, it turned out beautiful. I was really impressed. And it was funny because originally on the satin cording, I was just going to do this upper part, and then after I got it on, I'm like, oh no, now the quilt's out of balance because you have this heavy on the outside. So anyways, then I did the next layer in, and then I'm like, oh no, keep going girl, you got more to go.
So how many hours total do you have invested in this one quilt?
Including design time, I would say we're sitting at about 2,200 hours and about 3 years in the making.
Wow.
Yeah. There's a don't know if you want to know, there's a reason it ended up being called Perseverance.
How much did you have to rip out? Let's ask that question.
Well, I have spent I have spent, you know, those hours of, you know, our favorite stitch, the rip-it stitch.
Right.
For me, this quilt represents, it was a three-year journey. And in 2015, I just finished the quilt top and we were getting ready and my husband got a call that we were expecting our second grandchild, his daughter. And then in January, we had a phone call that she'd had a massive stroke and was airlifted to Kansas City, pregnant. And then in the March, her husband was getting ready to retire, Lieutenant Colonel out of the Army. He called us and asked us if we could bring Annika out so he could get everything wrapped up, because I made that choice to move back to family at that point for the support. So my husband flew out and got Annika and our three-year-old granddaughter, Ellie, and they came out while we're in the middle of a major home addition, because I wanted to put an in-law thing in for my mom so I didn't have to worry about her as she got older. And so we did that, and then Scott gets there in July, baby Kinsey's born 2 weeks later, and so now we have a family of four, plus the husband and I, major home addition, while I'm getting mom's house ready for market. And then November they moved out, December my father passed, and then same time found out my daughter was expecting. And then she ended up getting preeclampsia, so little Melody Grace came into the world approximately 6 weeks early. And so I finished up the quilt after Melody's entrance into the world, and I thought, you know, considering all the miracles, everybody's doing good, the quilt had to be called Perseverance. It represents many of God's blessings in a very challenging time in our life.
And that goes to show really how comforting quilts are on many levels.
Oh, yeah.
Both for you and other members that you might give a quilt to.
Oh, definitely. They're from the heart.
That's right.
Heart.
Now, I know we have some fun stuff on the back. Oh. So let's just pick up this corner here carefully and show them what the back of the quilt looks like. Look at all the colors of thread.
Yes. Well, kind of strange, but I figure if I'm going to go through 2,200 hours making a quilt, I want to see it from the back. So when you're doing all the ditch work around the applique, so I'd put colors and I'm not kidding. I'd then crawl underneath the long arm frame as it's coming together with a flashlight to see how it was looking. And so for me, it's just kind of one of those, it's neat. It's like the reverse image of the front. And so, yeah, a lot of fun.
And I don't see a single stop or start. So that means you really could turn it over and use the back if you wanted to.
Yes, I could. And it's one of those things. And there are a ton of start and stops on this quilt. So thank you, Bonnie. That's the biggest compliment yet.
I can't see them very well.
Okay. Well, hey, we don't have to use that. So I got really good at bearing threads.
Okay. Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
We're glad to have you as one of our top winners in this special contest that we've done this year.
It's an
and
honor.
We can't wait to see another quilt from you.
Oh, bless your heart. Thank you. Can I have a hug?
You can.
Thank you.
And for you out there, don't forget to enter your quilts. We'd love to have your quilts here at AQS Quilt Week to share. And the rules are all online at quiltweek.com.